Myself, Dr. Shalini Lihitkar from Department of Library and Information Science, Rashtrasanta Tukdoji Maharaj, Nagpur University. Welcome to this international e-conference. Today we are going to see the innovative use of open educational resources in teaching and learning for sustainable development. Friends, the period of COVID-19 has changed everything of our life. Especially for academic community, this is a tremendous digital turn to establish our digital academic identity and to make your digital footprint in the online teaching and learning. And this can be possible by understanding and using open educational resources for our teaching purpose so that we can survive in this digital age. So this presentation basically endeavors to throw a light on what is meant by open access, open educational resources, and how to search for the journals, how to search for the thesis, and searching of IR, and how to search from the online learning platform. And we will also see what are the various useful resources which we can take for our teaching and learning purpose and use of open educational resources in teaching and learning purpose. So friends, as we all of you know that advancement in science and technology has made a tremendous impact on every field, and libraries are no exceptions to this, because e-resources are now becoming a more common in libraries, and all these e-resources services, every individual information services to the users are the order of the day. Because some of the institutions, they may not be providing these e-resources, subscription-based e-resources, but this can be possible if we use these open educational resources in the higher education institutions. So friends, when we see this internet searching, there are three types of surfaces are available on the web. First is surface web. Once we see or once we use this Google, then it will going to give the results for only 4%. And second is the deep web. All the academic information are available in this deep web. And third one is dark web. So whenever you are searching from the Google, that means only you are getting a 4% result. So there is a need to know about this deep web. And all these academic information are available in this deep web, where you can get the 90% of result. So for this, we have to know what are the different type of sources, that is primary sources, secondary sources, tertiary sources. And you can see this slide regarding primary sources. All these sources are coming under primary sources. Secondary sources, these indexes, bibliography, indexing periodicals, abstracting periodicals, reference books, all these are coming under secondary sources. And from our school education, we are using all type of resources, but that may be in the traditional form. But if we are using this traditional information resources in the platform of digital world, then it is called as e-resources. So these e-resources are available on the open access platform. So what is meant by open access? It is a resource in digital, online, free of cost and free of most of the copyright and licensing restrictions. So there is no limitation we can use for our teaching purpose, learning purpose. And this is, we don't have to subscribe all these resources. This is free of cost. Any users can read, download, copy, distribute or search or link. And even redistribution is also possible. With this help of open access resources, we can also crawl them for the indexing purpose and use them for any law, other lawful purpose. Only the attribution we have to provide to the authors. That is only the condition for e-resources. So don't you think whatever the e-resources are available in this digital world, we can use as an educator, you can use and reuse for teaching, learning and research purpose. And because this challenging time of COVID-19, several publishers have opened their e-resources or whatever resources they are having previously on the subscription mode, now they have converted into the open educational mode so that we can't use it for our teaching purpose. So whenever you use this open access resources, it is free and we can use for our research purpose, we can use for our teaching purpose, because it is free from the plagiarism. We can use it for our teaching purpose. It is also free from the teachers. It is also free for the teachers, because once you published in the open access platform, so accessible of all the open access resources are possible, and your visibility of publication is more. So automatically it will enhance the your research visibility once you publish in the open access platform. So friends, here you can see this mind map. This mind map is showing that open educational resources are categorized in the different platforms. For example, if you want to search the e-journals, then you can use this DOAJ site, that is Directory of Open Access Journals. If you want to access the open courseware, you can use this Swayamprabha, MIT courseware, CEC Consortia, EPG Padshala, Swayam, Sakshat, NCRT, then e-Gyanakosh. And if you want to search for the institutional repository, then you can use this DOAR, ROAD and ROAR. And if you want to search for the books, then it is you can use this Universal Digital Library, then Project Gutenberg, and DOAB site, National Digital Library of India, Free Science Information. And you can, if you want to search for the thesis, then you can go for NDLT, that is at international level. If you want to search the thesis, you can use Vidyanidhi. It is also there. Previously it was only thesis they are providing the access, but now they are also providing the other items in the open access platform. Shodhganga is also there, and Shodh Gangotri is also there. So these resources, open educational resources, you can use for the teaching and learning purpose. So let us see a quick view about all the such type of resources. First, we will see the DOAJ, Directory of Open Access Resources, and it was launched in 2003, and it contains total 14,715 journals, and you can see here that above 4 million records or articles are available. So don't you think this all resources we can use for our teaching and learning purpose? So once you want to search in the DOAJ site, you can go for the browse subject is there, and just I have given the keyword life sciences. So here you can see that how many records of for this particular subjects are coming, and it is a full text view can be also possible. All the records will come, and here you can, once you click on the particular article, then you will get the full text of the article. So another source is Google Scholar. Google Scholar will give you the peer-reviewed online academic journals and books, conference paper also they are providing, thesis and dissertation also they are providing. So instead of using the Google, you can search for the Google Scholar, which will give you all the scholarly content. And here you can find that 389 million documents are available in this Google Scholar. Then why we have to use this Google Scholar? Because it will give you the automatic alert. Whenever the new article is published on your subject, then it will give you the automatic alert. So for this, you can use this Google Scholar. They are also providing the facility of creating the author public profile and the facility of metrics of journals, which is from the point of view, it is a very good source, Google Scholar, where to publish, then how to publish in a good reputed journals or even in high impact factor. So this source can be also useful. So here is the homepage of this Google Scholar. Once you search for the biodiversity of sustainable development, so it will give you the records, and which is from 0.07 seconds. You can also search from the 2020-2019. So according to year wise also, you can search for this Google record, Google search. The next source is Shodh Sindhu. So it will provide you the access of 10,000 e-journals and near about 3 million, above 3 million records or e-books are also available. So previously this is the subscription based, but now during this COVID period, they are providing the free access to all type of resources among this Shodh Sindhu. Then once you want to search for the e-thesis, then you can use this Shodh Ganga site. Shodh Ganga is the site which Infibnet Center, they are maintaining this Shodh Ganga site. And here you can see that the repository has the ability to capture, index, store, disseminate and preserve e-thesis submitted by the research scholar. And there is a UGC regulation, each research scholar or university has to submit this thesis after the award of the degree. This is the homepage of the Shodh Ganga. You can search here, search facility is there, search and browse facility. So once you search for your subject, then you can see that for biology, I have given you the keywords that biology and life sciences. So biology 3,740 records are available. So all these records are coming under the full text platform. You can use for your teaching and learning purpose. Here just I have given one example that role of RNA in the regeneration process in Hydra. So this thesis is completed in 1978. You can see here that for after 43 years also, because of this digitization, because of this Shodh Ganga initiative from the Infibnet, you can also access this thesis which is completed in 1978. You can also see there if you want to go into the full text, all the chapters will be coming, and if you want to click on particular chapter, so full text will be also coming. There is a next site that Shodh Gangotri. So Shodh Ganga for searching the full text thesis and Shodh Gangotri for searching the synopsis, research proposal for PhD program and MRP also you can search. You can see here that 7,645 synopses are available in the Shodh Ganga site. This is the home page of the Shodh Ganga. You can search here or browse according to the university or department wise, research guide wise, title also you can search, keyword also you can search, or university wise also you can search. You can see here the result for life sciences. There are, this is the site of University of Mysore. Previously they are also providing for the thesis only, but now they are providing all type of items. It may be a conference proceeding or it may be a research article. So you can use all these particular resources for searching the thesis. And if you want to search for the international level, what are the thesis or dissertation available at international level, then you can search this Network Digital Library of Thesis and Dissertation. It is a very good source for searching the thesis at global level. And you can see here that above 5 million records or thesis are available in this Shodh NDLTD site. So this is the homepage of Network Digital Library of Thesis and Dissertation. And once you search for the your subject, it may be a biology, so 778 records are available. You can here search also full text. And here the special facility they are providing, you can also submit your thesis in this repository by registering for their site. So that can be also possible. The next site, if you want to search for the e-content or open courseware, you can use this EPG Pathshala. It is also the initiative from MHRD. And here 70 subjects at post graduation level, it is available. You can see here that very high quality curriculum based interactive contents are available in different subjects. It may be a social science, it may be a mathematics, it may be a science. So if you just click on this EPG Pathshala site, then you can search here. So total e-text are available, 20,000 e-text are available, 19,000 videos are available, and which is made by the 3,200 experts. You can also see here that 30,000 quiz are also available. So you can use for your purpose also. So this EPG Pathshala, this is the home page of EPG Pathshala. And if you want to search for the environmental science, you can see here that 530 records are available. Means 530 modules or e-contents are available in this environmental science. You can also take another subject also, like computer science, 633 records are available. So if you want to go into the depth of the environmental science, then you can just have a look in the paper or just scroll this button. Then you may having this screen, ecosystem structure, then functions. And you can also see, choose the modules. So there is a facility of e-text is also coming, learning more is also coming, and self-learning is also coming. So once you want to self-learn, so video will be open. So just in the next slide, this is my video, which is available in the EPG Pathshala for my subject. So like this, you can also search for your subject also. Then EPG is also providing three verticals platform. That is E-Adhyan is also there, and E-Adhyan for using this or providing this 700 plus e-books. Then they are also providing this UGC MOOCs, which is the vertical of SWAM, and all these e-contents are also available in this UGC MOOC. And E-Pathya is also there. So E-Pathya for the distance learning as well as campus learning mode, and it also facilitates the offline access. So this is a very good source, dear friends. We are also using this SWAM platform. It is the program which is initiated by the Government of India. And the main objective of this program is to take the best teaching and learning resources to all. So SWAM can be also used. This is the homepage of the SWAM, swam.gov.in. So you can take some of the courses from the SWAM. And credit can be also transferred to the university. You can take any course from the SWAM. They are also providing, for example, suppose if you are searching for the science, so all these basic modules will be also coming. You can run the video also. You can join the program with the help of the registration link they are providing. And they are providing also the assignments for submission. And after that, you will get the certificates for completion of your course. So this is the next site, SWAM Prabha channel. So this site is a group of 32 DTS channel, which is devoted to telecasting of high quality educational program, which is available 24/7. And this channel, Infibnet centers maintain this channel. This is the homepage of the SWAM Prabha channels. And they are also providing the higher education curriculum based course content. They are also providing the school education. They are also providing the curriculum based courses. And they are also providing the 11th and 12th students who are preparing for the competitive exam. So they are also providing some of the e-content with this DTH channel. Here you can see that you can search from the different subject, or you can also define according to the title also you can refine. You can see here that computer science, mechanical engineering. So n number of courses are available in this SWAM DTH channel. If you want to search for the life sciences, then you can search. You can also refine your search according to the learners. Like if you are your students are belonging to UG, then you can also refine your search. So like this, you can refine your search. Then next site is Sakshat. Sakshat is a very good site which will give you the school education also. They are providing undergraduate also, then postgraduate also, and they are also providing the other online platform. So this is the one platform from where you can go for different online learning platforms. Then next site is regarding MIT OpenCourseWare. MIT OpenCourseWare, it is an international university. And it will provide you the web education, publication of virtually all MIT course content. And you can see here that 2400 courses which are permanently available with this site. You can take one course or you can use all the material for your teaching and learning purpose. So this is the homepage of the MIT Courseware, You can find your course. 2400 courses are available in this, and you can search here in this search string. So after searching the life sciences, I will get different type of courses. And if you want to go into the depth of that course, then here you will see that different like subject it is coming, like bioengineering. Then course content like assignment, AV lectures, audiovisual lectures, audiovisual selected lectures. So all type of contents, whatever contents they are having, they are providing the course content, link to the course content. So friends, here if you want to go for any online learning platforms, so other platforms are also available, like eGANcoach is there, Nista is there, NROER is there, CECL also providing the e-content platform, eYantra for engineering, Badal is there, Spoken Tutorial is there, NCRT is there, Shagun is there, FOSI is there. If you want to use some of the open source software, then you can use with this FOSI. If you want to use the experiment, science experiment, then you can also choose this virtual labs. So n number of online platforms are available. Only the thing is you have to use that platform. This is the site regarding how to search the repository. So repository is a very good source of information. And here you can see that this directory, DOAR, Directory of Open Access Repository, it is a global directory of open access repository. You can search here. There is a search facility is also available. You can search here. Then the next type is you can search here journal articles. You can search here thesis. Books also you can search. So there is a different contents you can search in this repository. Then you can see here that if you search for the biology and biochemistry, 204 contents are available. Friends, this is the another source, Directory of Open Access Scholarly Resources, is a service offered by the ISSN International Center, and it will give you the free access to near about 1.8 million bibliographic records and more than 2 lakhs digital records. So this can be also used. This is the homepage of Directory of Open Access Scholarly Resources, and they are providing the access to the scholarly content. And this is the Registry of Open Access Repository Mandate and Policy. If you want your repository will be in the open access platform, so what will be the mandates and what will be the policy, you can see here from this. Then this is the another site which is maintained by the InfibNet, that is InfoPort. It is a subject gateway for Indian electronic resources, and it is a very good resource. Whatever the resources, electronic resources published from India, you can have the access through this site InfoPort. So here you can see that different type of sources are available. It may be a audio visual or other multimedia learning resources. It may be the library, archives or museum. It may be the electronic books. Any n number of electronic resources are searched from this InfoPort. Then if you want to search for the National Digital Library, this is the National Digital Library homepage, and here you can search the scholarly publication. Even you can search the data sets also, video sets also you can search, or journal and conference proceeding also you can search. Previously it only gives the access to the books, but now they are providing the access to all the scholarly content. So this is the National Digital Library of India site. Only the thing is you have to register. After that you will be given the password, and after that you can use all such type of resources. See here that they are providing the access to the books. They are providing access to articles, theses, video lectures, audio lectures, and even some manuscripts are also available in this National Digital Library of India. So if you search for your subject, it may be a biology or biotechnology or chemistry or biochemistry, you will get a number of video lectures, you will get books also, or you will get different type of web resources also. So they are providing about 6 million books in 70 languages, and see here that the statistics, n number of statistics is available here for thesis, audio lectures, and video lectures. Even here in National Digital Library of India, question papers are also available for your subject. So you can use all this teaching material or even this e-resources for your teaching and learning purpose. And this is the another site, friends, DOAB. This is the directory of open access books, and 29,130 academic peer reviewed books are available with this site. This is the homepage of this directory of open access books, and here you can see that earth and environmental sciences books are available. Then full text books are available. You can have the access in the full text books. Then this is the World Digital Library. This is the project by the Library of Congress. And this is the project with the support of UNESCO. They are also providing the access for educators, scholarly or general audience. They are providing the access to the scholarly material. This is the homepage of this World Digital Library. Any keywords you can type here and you can search. There is another source for searching the books. A million books are available in this site. Universal Digital Library, you can search. Then free science information is also there. You can search, like, see here that biology 37 books are also available. Not only they are providing the access to the books, but they are also providing the access to e-thesis. Then formulas also they are providing. Notes are also providing. So this is a very good source for science. You can use this source. There are another useful resources which you can use for your online platform also. Like e-Krishi Shiksha is there, EPUB is there, Krishi Kosh is there, Sera resources are also available. Enlist, this is a subscribe base, this is not available in the open access platform. But Book Bone is also there, Book Bub is also there, Digital Book Index is also there. Even Google Books, they are also providing the access to the books. Project Gutenberg is also there, Library of Congress. So these, all these resources you can use for your teaching and learning purpose. So friends, if you are publishing in the open access platform, if you are using the open access resources, so it will enhance your research visibility. This is the site regarding how to enhance our research visibility, because nowadays for accreditation purpose, whatever we are publishing in the various platform, it should have some citation, then only our research will be valuable. So from that point of view, if you want to publish the article in the open access platform, then it will automatically enhance your research visibility. And for this, you can use a different type of researcher profiling tool. It may be a Scopus, it may be a Web of Science, it may be a Publon, it may be a Google Scholar. ARCID is also there, where you can open your research profile, create your research profile, and whatever you are publishing in all this platform, so you can just have a link to this platform so that your research visibility, your citation index will be increased. So from this point of view, these open educational resources are becoming very valuable alternative to improve the access to high quality educational content, and which is released under the open access license by the outstanding university worldwide. So this is a perfect source. If you are using this open educational resources, we can use this open educational resources for customization of our course material. We can use for creating the perfect course packet for our student. So friends, you can use all these such type of open access resources for teaching and your learning, and or even for the research purpose. So if you, it doesn't matter how many resources you have, but if you don't know how to use them, it will never be enough. So with this message, the Samuel Johnson, a very famous quote is there. He is saying that knowledge is of two kinds. We know a subject ourselves, or we know where to find the information about the subject. Friends, I know you are very good in your subject. And if you are also good in how to find the information about your subject, then it may be a very useful for the teaching community. So use such all type of open access resources and learn something new every day. So thank you for if you are having any questions, you can give some you can ask the questions on my mail also, or through phone also you can ask the questions. And I would like to thanks to the organizers, especially Dr. Reddy sir, Dr. Patil sir for giving this opportunity to express my thought in this international e-conference. So thank you once and all, and thank you to all the participants for patience listening. Thank you.